before we start the video, let me give you a brief introduction about myself. I'm Chandresh Mahajan, who is founder and chief educator at Exergic, which is India's most trusted and comprehensive institute for online GATE preparation. I got an All India rank 37 from GATE Mechanical Engineering, and I am an ex-Indian Oil officer, having 6+ years of teaching experience as of now. To know more about our GATE courses, you can contact us on these details. Also, you can download Exergic GATE preparation app from Google Play Store. The link is available in the description of video. Now let's have a look at a previous year GATE question from 2017 Mechanical Engineering. This is such a question which is not framed properly. There are many faults in this question, and as I will solve it, I will tell you what are those faults, and you cannot ignore those faults. Look, those of you who are a beginner may not know about this, but those of you who have appeared in GATE once, twice, or maybe more than that, they are knowing it, that every year there are certain questions in GATE which are not considered to be a good or a proper question. There are mistakes in the question itself, mistakes in the options given, sometimes mistakes in the answer key of IITs, what they propose, right? Obviously, you can challenge it later on. This is one of those questions which is poorly framed. It is not a good question, but the range of this question was very relaxed. That is the only reason why many of you ignored this question. Many of you did not understand that why this question is a question which can teach you some things, which can bring your focus on those silly mistakes that you can do in other questions. So when I'm solving this question, don't think that you know this question already, you know how to solve this, it's a very regular question. Don't do this. Pay attention to everything, and by the end of this example, you will understand that how good questions can be framed using the same data, where some of you will make the mistakes. Let's have a look at the question. Question says that a strip of 120 mm width and 8 mm thickness is rolled between two 300 mm diameter rolls. So you have a strip, the width of the strip is 120 mm, its thickness is given as 8 mm. It is rolled between two rolls of 300 mm diameter to get a strip of 120 mm width. So width is constant, width is same, right? And 7.2 mm thickness. So anyway, we consider the width to be same unless something else is mentioned. So width is going to remain constant, which is 120 mm. And in the rolling process, the thickness will reduce from 8 mm to 7.2 mm. Okay. Obviously, since there is reduction in thickness, width is constant. So speed with which it is moving ahead will change. When its thickness has been reduced, the speed of movement will increase, if you can equate the volumes at inlet and outlet, right? So the speed of strip at exit is 30 meter per minute. So let me draw this diagram first, and then we will move further in the discussion. So its width, which is not shown here, is perpendicular to the whiteboard, 120 mm. Thickness of 8 mm reduced to 7.2 mm, and the velocity of the strip at the exit is 30 meter per minute. So let's say this section is section number 1, this section is section number 2, and here at the section number 2, the velocity of the strip is equal to 30 meter per minute. Any idea about the velocity at section 1? Whether it should be higher, lower, or same? As I just told you, if you use the concept of constant volume, I have already told you that, you will realize that velocity at section 1 should be lesser than the velocity at section 2. You can just equate the volumes, or the volume which is flowing through this rolls per unit time. So even at this point, at this very point, a small question can be framed that find out the velocity at the entry of the rolls, where it is entering. It's a one mark question. You just have to equate the volumes. If I quickly ask you to do that, what should be the velocity at the entry? Its thickness is 120 here and there at both the sides, right? So at the entry, thickness 120 means width is 120, thickness is 8, and velocity with which it is moving means the distance which it is covering per unit time, that is same as the velocity at the entry. So this is the volume flowing through the entry per unit time, width, thickness and its length per unit time, which is velocity at entry, right, is equal to how much is the volume moving out of the exit, which is equal to width is same 120 multiplied by 7.2 multiplied by V at exit. 120, 120 cancelled. So if you solve it, you put the value of velocity of exit, you will get the velocity of entry as 27 meter per minute. You may be thinking that sir, question is not even asking about velocity at entry. Why are you finding it out? There are two reasons for it. One is to give you a quick idea of a very easy and common type of question that is asked from this, although we have discussed this already in theory part. And secondly, you will see very soon when I will discuss this question, you will very soon realize that why I discussed about velocity at entry. Just keep in mind that velocity at entry is 27 meter per minute. Okay, at the exit it is given to us. Okay, now further the question is saying that there is no front or back tension, so there is no tension applied from the back or from the front. So what it is going to ensure, why this statement is written here, it will ensure that the neutral plane does not shift anywhere. Neutral plane is going to stay where it is, right? I have already told you the significance of front and back tension, so that is not going to be applicable here. Assuming uniform roll pressure of 200 megapascal in the roll bite and 100% mechanical efficiency, it is asking you to assume that roll pressure is uniform of 200 megapascal. This statement is crucial. I will tell you very soon. And 100% mechanical efficiency. Tell me one point, that mechanical efficiency, where this is going to be used? Suppose this mechanical efficiency was not 100%. Suppose it was 95%. So where exactly do you have to use this efficiency? Where this efficiency is going to be used actually? In this part, friction has to be present. Where it is deforming, there friction is needed. We know that, we have discussed that. But in case of bearings, where these two rolls are rotating, in those bearings, friction is unwanted. You do not want that friction. So at these points, it is telling you that mechanical efficiency is 100% means if you are going to give some power input to these rolls, total power will be received by the rolls. There will be no loss of that power in any of the mechanical systems, mainly in the bearings. It is important to know, because here it does not matter. 100% is given, just forget about it. But if it was given 98%, then obviously your approach will change, right? So this is the reason of mechanical efficiency, as again, we have already discussed these things. So assuming the roll pressure of this much and efficiency full, the minimum total power in kilowatt required to drive the two rolls is how much? So the question is asking you to find out the minimum power required to drive these two rolls. And obviously we are considering 100% mechanical efficiency, no losses we are considering. So the power is obviously going to be minimum power required. So that is not something to be worried about. But when you go on to find out the power required for rotational motion, it is T multiplied by omega, torque required multiplied by angular velocity of the rotating component. We are finding out the power required for the rolls. So torque given to the rolls and angular velocity of the roll. But now pay attention to the question. Has question given you anything about the angular velocity of the roll? No. It has not given the rotations per minute or the angular speed. Nothing is mentioned. Only one data is given about speed, and that is the speed of the strip at the exit. V2 is given as 30. Can you use that velocity to find out the angular velocity of rolls? You cannot do that, because that velocity is more than the angular velocity of roll. I have already told you that how there is a slip existing in case of rolling, which makes sure that at the entry, the roll is moving faster. At the exit, roll is moving slower as compared to strip, or strip is moving faster. But there is a point, rather a small region between entry and exit, where Both of the roll as well as the strip are moving with the same velocity for a very small fraction of distance, almost like a line, but in reality it's a small area. So in that region, both the velocities of the roll and the strip are same. There you can use, if you know that velocity, which is the velocity of neutral plane, right? That plane is called as neutral plane. So if you know the velocity of the strip at neutral plane, then you can use that velocity to find out the velocity of roll. You can imagine that velocity as the tangential velocity of the roll at that point. And then if you know the tangential velocity of the roll, you can use V is equal to R omega to find out the omega of roll, which is required here. But question has not given you any data that how can you find out the velocity at this point, at the neutral plane. And if I tell you, there are certain ways to do it. If I start doing that here, it will get really complicated. It can be done mathematically, trust me, but it will get really complicated for this case. And honestly, it is not required for GATE. It's a poorly framed question. It does not mean that we have to know of all those ways in which we can find out the position of neutral plane, even when data is not given to you. So in this case, using any of the other concepts that I know to solve, to find out the velocity of the strip at the neutral plane is really not required, really not a concept to be used in GATE, and it will cross the limit of 2 marks question, right? So this is not the way to solve it. Ideally, this question should give you something that gives you an idea of how much is the velocity at the neutral plane. Okay. Now, some of you may think that, sir, let's take the average. That's why I calculated the velocity at the entry. Now you can understand. If I know the velocity at entry and exit, can I take the average to find out the velocity of neutral plane? I cannot do that. I have already told you what exactly is neutral plane, how it comes in action, right? What is its significance? And obviously the variation here, the variation of thickness is not linear. It's curved already, right? So you cannot just assume that thickness is varying linearly, so velocity will also vary linearly. We cannot assume that because thickness is not varying linearly. So if some of you are suggesting that, sir, please take their average and that will give you the velocity of neutral plane, that is incorrect. I have already told you that. You have understood what is neutral plane. This should not come to your mind. And let me tell you that maximum sources, maximum, almost all sources that you refer to solve previous year question, they have not addressed this issue. They have not talked about it. They have just used the velocity of exit to find out the omega, which is totally incorrect, right? Not only using concepts, but from the point of view of this question also. How? The answer for this question, the range of this question was given as 8.5 to 10. Look, in this question, I'm just not solving this question, right? We can solve this question in the wrong way and be happy about it. I'm not going to do it. I will tell you a lot of these concepts and small things that nobody is going to tell you. The range of this question in GATE was given as 8.5 to 10. Now, if you don't know this, in almost every case of NET question, almost every case, there can be a rare exception here and there. I don't know about that. But in almost every question of NET in GATE, whatever key is given to you, exact answer is exactly mid of the range. Exact answer for this case cannot be 8.7 because it is lying in this range of 8.5 to 10, but it is not exactly center of 8.5 and 10. Right? An exact answer cannot be 9.7 or 9.6. In maximum sources, you will see that they have given answer as 9.6. That is incorrect. Right? Exact answer for this question, according to the key given by the GATE, will be exactly mid of these two, which is 9.25. And if you use this velocity of exit of strip and you solve the question, you are not going to get this answer. Okay? GATE did only good thing in this question that they gave the range very relaxed. This is the only reason why many of you or many of your seniors could solve this question and there was no chaos about this question as such. So in this question, how do you actually calculate the omega of roll? Please don't take the 30 value. I know some of you think that this source has used this value as 30, so we have to use it as 30. Many of the students that I see are very rigid that it has said, they have told me that it has to be 30, we have to use it this way, so it will be used this way. These things are not that much direct and simple. If you have understood rolling, you will realize that it's not something that has a single way to solve questions. To analyze rolling, numerous types of theories are available. If your source or your whatever, from wherever you are covering this, has told you only one way to do it, then it does not mean that that is the only way to solve it. There are more than one ways to solve it, not only for gate, but also in real analysis. There are numerous theories given to analyze rolling, and new theories keeps coming. Okay, so don't be very rigid that this is the only way to solve it. This is how it is written in that book or that source. I have referred way more sources than you can, trust me. And that is why what I am telling you is not something which is rigid, that you have to do it only. I will tell you 2-3 different situations, and depending upon the situation, you have to pick the right way. In this case, in this question has given you the velocity at the exit of the strip. Okay, that velocity conceptually is incorrect to find the angular velocity of roll. What you have to do, you have to find out the velocity at the entry, take their average, which is going to be 28.5 meter per minute, and this value slightly increase. Why increase? I can explain it here, but that is not a very productive use of your time as well as my time. Okay, there are very less chances that this mistake will be repeated in gate. Gate will not do this again. If it does, question will be definitely challenged, everybody will get the marks, right? But still, what you have to do, take their average and increase this value slightly, not decrease, increase. Take it as 29 meter per minute. And as I told you, why increase, why not keep same? Don't ask these questions. It will take a lot of unproductive time to explain it, and your time also will be wasted, my time will also be wasted. So in this case, we will take the velocity of the neutral plane as roughly, approximately 29. All right, how? We took their average of both of them, and then we simply increased it slightly. You can take 28.8, 28.9, right? There is one more advantage in this question, why we can do this. Because it has been mentioned that you have to assume uniform roll pressure. Now, let us come to the discussion of uniform roll pressure for this specific question. Although I have in the very previous lecture explained you everything about the roll pressure, uniform roll pressure, but still for this question, I will take few minutes and tell you that. Now, coming to torque here. The value of torque here, how can you find it out? I have told you already that you have to find out the rolling load or roll separating force, which is going to act like this. And then you have to just multiply that force with the distance from the point of rotation. That will give you the torque, right? There are a lot more concepts here, and since you know about those concepts, I am not going to go into the details of those concepts for this question, since in the very previous lecture I have explained you that. And as I told you, one more mistake is present in this question. Question has given you uniform roll pressure. Uniform is fine. We know that pressure is going to vary from entry to exit, and how it varies and everything we know. For the simplicity, almost every question is going to give you uniform roll pressure. It's going to assume uniform roll pressure. That roll pressure is not changing, it is uniform. But question has given you roll pressure. That is totally incorrect. In any of the standard ways to define roll pressure and to solve this question, you cannot have roll pressure. You have to have average roll pressure or specific roll pressure, because roll pressure always acts radially. The roll pressure is going to act radially. At the center, all the pressure will be directed. Again, I'm telling you, this question and whatever I'm telling you, you may see some things other than what I'm telling here and there, maybe in some single source or in different source. Don't be confused. I have referred a lot more sources than you can think of. So whatever I'm telling you, even if it deviates from what you may know from any specific source, forget about it. I know about it. That is not the correct way. Roll pressure is always radial at the center, right? And if you go on to directly find out the torque using this pressure, you are going to have zero torque because it is directed at the center, right? I have told this to you already. In this case, rather than giving you the average roll pressure or the specific roll pressure, which is vertical, question has directly given you the roll pressure, which is towards the center. So you cannot find out the average roll pressure or specific roll pressure directly from the roll pressure, right? Again, one more incorrect way of giving the value of pressure. So torque calculation is also not going to be very much exact. Omega calculation was obviously not exact. We have to do some of the manipulation. Even torque value will not be exact one here. Ideally, question should give you average roll pressure or it should give you average flow stress. These two things question should give you in order to find out the torque requirement. Directly roll pressure, whenever it is given, again I am telling, whatever source, does not matter. If directly roll pressure is given, it is absolutely going to be an approximate calculation. Exact calculation cannot be done using the roll pressure which is directed towards the center. Clear? So in this case, we have to take the approximation that this roll pressure is the average roll pressure, is the specific roll pressure. And using that, we are going to calculate the things forward. Till this point, whatever I have told you, please note that I have not even started the question yet. I have not started solving the question. If I just wanted to get the answer somehow, it just needs 3-4 minutes and I can just do it like that. And I will tell you, this is the answer. You are happy. I am happy. Just move on. But that's not the way that I prefer to teach concepts, especially when I'm discussing the numericals, right? I hate that way to explain things. Before starting the question, as you have seen in thousands of previous cases, that I always try to explain the things about the question, do the 360 degree analysis of that question before actually solving it. So in this case, even before solving it, we know that we are not going to get the exact answer. T as well as omega are approximate, and that is why even this is a previous year gate question given by IITs, it is not a proper question, right? Data is missing. Things which are given are not given you properly and correctly. And this can happen. I know that some of the beginners can think that, sir, how come you say this? How come IITs make incorrect question? How can they give incorrect question? But if you ask any of your seniors, they will give you a very good idea. I also have given you the idea that every year it happens in GATE. This is unfortunate, but it happens. So there will be some questions which when solving in GATE, you will stuck. You will feel that question is not right. Something is wrong somewhere and you may be true, right? So please don't panic in GATE when you see such questions which can differ from what you know. There are certain questions like this, but please don't do that. Every question that you cannot solve, you just blame on IITs and think that it's a wrong question. Don't do that. It happens only for a couple of years. Sorry, in couple of questions in any given year. So out of 2-3 sets, in one or two questions it can happen. So please don't do that. Whatever question you are not able to solve, you think that it's a wrong question, let's move to the next one. Don't do it like that. Okay, so in this case things are very simple. If you want to assume this as average roll pressure and assume that this is the value of velocity of neutral plane, what we need to do to find out the torque, we need to find out the value of force, then multiply it with this distance, right? The distance from the center of rotation. We can find out the torque and then we can use this velocity to find out the omega. Let me do it quickly and save your time. So in this case, in order to calculate the value of torque, we need to multiply this force, roll separating force or rolling load, with the distance r. This force, as I have told you, we can calculate using the stress, mean flow stress, or the average pressure, average roll pressure, the specific roll pressure with the projected area. Question has given you, unfortunately, the roll pressure. So you have to directly use the roll pressure here. You have no other option. And multiply that with the projected area, which is projected length. This is the projected length, LP, multiplied by the width. LP is root R delta H, as we know. So we can calculate LP. R value is not known to us directly, and no question is going to give you the value of R directly. You have to figure it out from the question. This question mentions one thing straight away, that a uniform roll pressure is existing. So this roll pressure is uniform. In a way, it is a uniformly distributed load, like a UDL. And for the UDL, obviously, the effective force is going to act at the center of that, right? So effective force will be passing from the half distance of the contact length. So R has to be 0.5 times of contact length. Just using the concepts of strength of materials, you can figure it out. Even if it was not given, you had no other option but to take it as 0.5, because when nothing is mentioned in case of rolling, I have told you, you have to take it as hot rolling, and for hot rolling, the value of lambda is 0.5. Means we assume that force is going to act at half the distance of the contact region. At midway of the contact region, it will act. So this is how we are going to figure out the value of R. So LP, two places we have where we have LP. LP is root R delta H. So when multiplied, it will become R delta H. Just put the values, pressure value you put, R delta H you put, W value you put. Please ensure that units are correct. The unit of pressure is given in megapascal. So Newton per mm square. So force units in Newton and the unit of length in mm. That will be ensured. Radius is also given in mm. It is 300 mm diameter. So radius is 150. Delta H for this case is 8 minus 7.2. So delta H is equal to 0.8 mm. Right? 8 minus 7.2. How much is the change in the thickness? That value you can put here. And when you solve it, you are going to get a value in Newton mm. Right? You have to convert that into Newton meter, because question is asking you it into what? Into kilowatt. So ultimately, you have to find it out in what? Using Newton meter units, then convert it into kilowatt. So this is the value of torque that we have got. Let's quickly find out the value of omega. To find out the angular velocity of roll, we have to use the tangential velocity of roll divided by radius. Just like any body which is performing circular motion, V is equal to R omega, right? The velocity, tangential velocity of roll, is equal to the velocity of strip at the neutral plane. So VNP divided by R. VNP approximately we have calculated as 29. It can be slightly higher or slightly lower than that, right? It's an approximation. I have already told you how we have reached that approximation. If you put that value here, 29 divided by 60 will give you the velocity of neutral plane in meter per second. It is given in meter per minute. Small things here and there which can be dangerous in exam. The radius is given as 150 mm. So you have to convert that into meter here. Why? Because we are using the unit here in meter, right? So units of length are in meter, the units of time are in second. If you simplify it, you will get the omega as 3.222 radian per second. This is the omega value. To find out the power required, you simply have to multiply T with omega and then double it. Again, a small point of mistake. You have two rolls here. You need to drive both of them individually. They demand power to be driven. So T omega multiplied by 2 will give you the correct answer. If you do that, 2 multiplied by this value of T multiplied by this value of omega, you will get it as 9.28 kilowatt. Still not the exact value. The exact value for this question should be 9.25. Range given by the gate was 8.5 to 10. But as I am repeating it here, go and check out in any other source. They will simply use the velocity of exit of strip and just use that to get the answer, which will come as 9.6, very close to this end, very far from this end, right? I will tell you one better way in which this question could have been framed. Let me tell you that. Suppose this question is asked again in gate. But that question will be correct, slightly better if they give options for this question. They give four options for this question. And what you can do then? In that case, what you can do, you can use the velocity at the exit only to do the calculation. The velocity at the exit, which is a higher value than the velocity of roll, will give you a higher value of omega, will give you a higher value of power, right or not? And if the options are framed in such a way that suppose if I use the exit velocity, I get the power as 9.6 kilowatt. Then what does it mean? It means that obviously in actual case, the power will be less than 9.6 kilowatt. Right or not? Because 9.6 I will get if I use this velocity, the velocity at the exit, which is higher than the velocity of roll. So omega that I will get will be a higher value. So power will be a higher value. So in reality, 9.6 kilowatt that I will get using this velocity will be higher power than actually it will be required, because in reality, omega of roll will be less than the omega which I will calculate using this velocity, right or not? So if in the question options are given like this, 9.6, then 10.4, then 11.2, and then there's an option of 9.1. Suppose this is a question in GATE. Same question is asked like this. What option should you tick? You should tick option A. That's the correct one. Because when you are using the exit velocity, you are getting 9.6, which is not possible, right? Velocity of neutral plane will be lesser. Omega will be lesser. Power will be lesser. You have only one option lesser than that value, which is option A. That's the correct option. So if this question, let's assume a hypothetical situation, is asked again, but this time it is asked with these options, then it's not a perfect question, but still a question which you can easily tick option A as the correct one. So I hope from this example, you understood a lot of things, not only the conceptual things, rather conceptual things we have discussed already in the previous and lectures before that. But here you need to understand, you need to develop a mindset where you should not waste a lot of your time in the exam. Whenever you're solving a question and by chance you stuck such a question which you can really see and observe that something is wrong somewhere, I am telling only if you have prepared well. If you have just covered the syllabus hardly, you have not solved good questions and you stuck in some question, then please blame yourself and not the IITs. But suppose even after doing everything, you stuck on a question like that, where you don't know what to do and you feel that something is wrong in the question, then there is a slight possibility of happening it. All right. So please don't waste 5, 10 minutes, 20 minutes on a single question. Don't take it on your personal ego that how come I am not able to get the answer? I should be able to solve it. Every question, no matter how easy or how difficult, it will give you a maximum of 2 marks, not more than that, right? So don't get attached to any question. Don't take it on your ego. If you cannot solve it in 5-7 minutes maximum, move on to the next one.